next step in the process is to resaw the material. I'm using a bandsaw made by the CH Wood Company out of Syracuse, New York, manufactured sometime probably around 1900 to 1910. Originally, this piece of equipment was powered by a steam-powered boiler, as evidenced by the large flywheel on the back of the tool. But today, I'm using an 11-horsepower gas engine that I've hooked to it that seems powerful enough to get through anything I want to shove in it. When I first started using the tool, I began to experience a lot of the same problems that one experiences with a standard bandsaw, only a lot more serious. One of those problems, or the primary problem I experienced, was the blade wanting to wander and drift in the material as I shoved large pieces of stock through it. The folks over at Cook Saw in Alabama, who's a manufacturer of a portable sawmill, helped me to understand an important blade dynamic. And that is, we have to understand exactly how the blade is manufactured. First, it's a flat piece of steel with the teeth or the serrations cut in it. Then that is cut to length and welded in a loop. Once welded in a loop, it's stretched over the bandsaw tires and put under a high degree of tension. When that happens, the blade has a natural tendency to want to have a slight cup to it. That cup, or mild arch that's in the blade, causes the blade to want to wander and drift in the material. So the solution, or the remedy, is to put a reverse dish in the blade, or a reverse cup, so that once the blade is under a high degree of tension, it's nice and perfectly flat at the cutting deck. Once I figured this out, I was able to get a nice, flat, straight cut without any difficulty. We've experimented with some different types of fences, but I've found that if I put a chalk line on the board or a pencil line, I'm able to get just as accurate of a cut by eye as I am by using any other method. So with that, we're going to change the blades and take a look at how we resaw. That's about absolutely perfect. You can see that this material has some very nice tight vertical grain here and is full of lightered or pitch. Some people refer to that as fat lightered, and lightered is the very, very high concentration of sap or pitch. This, of course, at one time was a very useful product in colonial America, creating the entire naval stores industry from the longleaf pine tree. More on that later. We'll cut the other pieces and go to the next step. No problem for the big saw.